sister away. You got me on my knees again.
Mine on?
I am recording.
I am recording.
I am recording. I am the recording bot for OhnoCoho. So are we go for team alpha?
We are go for team alpha.
All right.
We are go.
So we're not okay. So basically we've got Pam, Dread, and OhnoCoho.
Hi there.
Hello.
How's it going?
we're just doing this is just a little quote single player unquote, but it's actually with three people, so it's not really all that single.
Well, yep.
So Dread, would you like to go first in explaining what you're doing?
I am finding creative ways to unstick my cart, and I think it worked.
Yeah, no, you have to pick it up.
No, I've fought with it. I made it listen to me. I'm like, do you know who I am?
You will respect
me. I brought you into this world. I can take you out.
Did you shake your fist at it? ooh, brandish your axe. Yeah, he doesn't like that. The cart doesn't like the axe. He gets all nervous, and you know, his some of the water comes out from his steam engine. Yeah.
Well, this was a pool cart.
Oh.
Well, he doesn't deserve respect, anyways. okay, I'll be brief what I'm doing. So this is part of what I'm looking at right now is actually let me just show you.
You make a roundabout?
Yeah, it's a roundabout. So the idea being that there's two ways in and out of the base, and you pull in one way. You can pull in like this, right? And then you can, I've described this before, but you pull in right between the two buildings, and then you can just keep going and when you want to leave. And then it's going to turn a corner here, and then it's going to come up. Now, and then at some point up here, and then around through here somehow, and then to this ramp, and then down.
Okay.
That's it. So.
I didn't realize you were going this far out. The back part of the loop.
I wanted to leave myself room for growth. So you know, if I wanted to build a skyscraper,
mm-hmm.
I could.
Or a very fat building.
Yes. And Dread, I said thank you in my my title of my previous episode, but you can see that I'm using the patented Dread. Dread Pirate Duo method of ramping, where you take out a whole bunch of the stuff underneath it, and if this isn't enough, I'll take out more. So I've done that on this one and the one over here. What's that?
So this is a technique.
Technically, yes, but placing the block, placing the ramp down, is tricky if there's only one.
So now do you put stone over this?
No.
Okay, so this is just going to be a dirt ramp with the spaces underneath it.
Yes.
Okay, now what happens if you take that dirt out that's underneath it now? Will it stay up?
It levitates. Okay. These are magic ramps.
Okay.
Yeah. They use, they have special powers.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Gotcha. Gotcha.
That's the best answer I got for you.
So, Dread, is what the empty space underneath what solved the problem? Is that what?
So it's a combination of empty space and roads.
Okay.
What we think is going on, and it's because I don't know for sure, but when you have the ramp on top of like just say plain dirt, there's a chance that in the background there could be plants growing on it, a tree, something like that that's slated to grow there.
Right.
The cart sees that even though we don't, and they'll get caught up on it. You can see some of my early videos in Eco. You'll see my cart just getting stuck, and then I get catapulted somewhere.
Yep.
Right.
Ramp. So we had to put a space underneath, and the space underneath seemed to help, except for if we didn't make it road underneath at the very bottom, it would think it was on whatever material was underneath that ramp, and it was causing a problem.
I didn't.
Two empty spaces may work, or a road and then an empty space might work.
I didn't put road down in this particular instance. So we'll see. If I have an issue, I can always. Ramps are easy to pick up. I can pick the roads up and the ramps up and then tamp down and make road.
So this ramp right here at the very beginning, that's got an empty space under it too, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Absolutely.
An empty space here. But now this part up here does not have an empty space.
You mean this right here?
Right.
That's because I needed something to put it down on.
Oh, okay.
You have to have something there to put it down on. You can't just sort of, it doesn't, it won't let you place
it. But once it's down, you can remove it.
That is correct. Once it's down, you can remove it, and then it'll work correctly. Or at least mostly correctly.
Gotcha.
So that's sort of the approach I've been taking is I usually fiddle with it, or to take it all out, and then if I run into trouble, I'll just pull more out and go from there. Right.
Gotcha.
Right. Oh, Pam, I didn't ask you what you're doing.
Well, I've been cooking up a storm over the last couple of episodes, and I have quite a stock in my store, and somebody did buy stuff, so it must have been you.
Yep.
And I took the huckleberries that they paid with and stuff like that and put them into storage. But I didn't really have anything to cook today because right now my store is pretty full. So I'm just spending a day following you around.
I just ate bread and my delta went down 56.3.
Ooh.
Yeah, isn't that awesome?
Mm-hmm.
All right, my plan for today. I don't want to cut. So, Dred, did you get your cart free?
I got my cart free, and I'm working on trying to build a room for a industry table, which requires my walls to be corrugated steel, because that's cheap.
Oh, wow.
So I have a question. Have you ever heard of corrugated steel?
I've heard of corrugated metal.
Right, that's what I've heard.
Isn't
of, but not corrugated steel.
Wouldn't that be
steel.
Tin?
That's what I thought corrugated metal was tin.
Yeah.
Well, I'm used to seeing corrugated metal in sheets, right?
Yeah.
And it's just wavy. So right. You'll see it on rooftops a lot.
Yeah, that's where tin roofs.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought. I thought they were tin.
Yeah. I was just curious because I've heard you say that before, that it's corrugated steel, and I'm like, I've never heard of corrugated steel before. So I was just curious, that's all. So awesome. I am continuing the build on the thing. Oh, I should show this. The back
so how
wall
expensive is corrugated steel?
Yeah, how is
it? It's a couple ingots. I just had I just pumped. I just pumped about 1,900 skill points in to bring it down.
Oh god,
it's a lot of skill points.
Yeah, I pumped a whole bunch into a bunch of things. I had 8,000. Now I'm down to 5,800. People sort of go, "Oh wow, you got 5,800 points," but when you get at this level, it doesn't take much to use them up.
Yeah, I've got 3,789, but that's because I've come pretty close, I think, to maxing.
To what?
Maxing it out.
Cut off there for a sec.
Oh, sorry, I came pretty close to maxing out my skill tree.
Really?
Well, maybe not totally maxed out, but I'm up in the 600s on everything.
600s.
It's going to cost me 600 to go up one more level. I'm up on level 4 on everything.
Wow.
Everything's at level 4 except for molecular gastronomy, but that hasn't been filled out yet. It doesn't do anything. And culinary arts, molecular gastronomy. So I'm holding on to points and not putting anything more in there until 5.5 and I see which way that skill tree is going. That's the whole reason I haven't gone up to level 5, which is max on all my cooking stuff, because it would deplete all my points and then some, and I wouldn't have anything left for tailoring, which I want to do in 5.5, and this skill tree wherever it's going. But I have to date 4,566 points invested in cooking, 514 points invested in research, 619 points invested in survival, and 77 points in civics, and 6 points in carpentry. And that's it.
I have 1,315 points in masonry, 1,020 in smithing, 796 in survival, 586 in engineering, 436 in carpentry, and then 376 in research, 13 in civics. So mostly masonry and like building stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because,
I wasted 487 points in agriculture. That does nothing. I mean, carpentry, you kind of have to start off with to get anything. So I put 321 points into that.
Yeah.
78 into civics because there wasn't a whole lot. I put 0 into cooking because I'm relying solely on Pam to feed me. 2159, so 2,159 points in engineering. 845 in masonry. I did a lot of research, so I have 2793 in research. But my biggest one is smithing. I've got 4,047. And then survival, I've got 392, which almost all of that is like the hunting aspect, so I could kill things and actually bring home the carcass.
yeah.
Right.
No, I hear you about that one, that's for sure. The targeting on some of the building is tricky. Now, I have to see how this is going to work. Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, like you mean targeting? Like, try to get your blocks to fit where you want them?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's... I'll be honest with you. I really think that based on the tool you have, you should have some sort of cursor in the middle that kind of helps you decide where things are. Because at least in Minecraft, something. Like, in Minecraft, you don't always have something like that, but you could easily see where the next block is going, and then you can, like... go to a pixel above it. You get to a point where you get to a pixel above it, and it'll put the block above it. It just makes that a lot easier. So if they can kind of replicate that experience, that'd be better.
Oh, I know what I was going to tell you. You know how with brick, when you put it up against something, it has that nice little border that goes around it, so you get the decor? Somebody came in to the official Eco Discord channel complaining that it does that. They think it looks awful. They think it looks terrible. Take it out. Just make it go flat up against, you know, masonry or wood. Not.
Really?
And I'm like, no.
I think that looks really nice.
I know. I do too. I think it looks lovely.
So I like that border. But mm-hmm. I think what they're talking about, at least from what you were saying, what I think is they're talking about when you get the brick that has the three central bricks in it. You know what I mean? Like, you get the block, and it changes to where it has these three bricks in it. Or, I'm sorry, not three. Like, five bricks, I'm sorry. But, like, it puts, like, a middle column in there of these
weird
colored
bricks. I see where you're talking about, next to the door over here. Yeah.
Yeah, and mortared stone does that, too, and I hate that. I hate that particular texture. I like when you have a wall of it. You have, like, the outer edge. That's really cool, but that one... texture, I hate it.
Yeah, see, I kind of like, I actually like it with those different colored bricks kind of in the middle there. At least around the doors and stuff where I've seen it. Maybe it looks odd in other places, but it looks really good around doors.
Maybe if they had a tool that let me go through and pick which brick texture I wanted, you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. with a texture change.
Right.
Like, so I could use that as a design element.
Empyrean.
Exactly.
Oh, excuse me. I had something in my throat there for a second.
If they could implement that system, that would be fantastic.
You mean something, I don't know, you could call it a symbol tool or a paint tool.
A paintbrush?
Or a paint tool of some sort? Mm-hmm. I'm just spitballing here.
Decorative tool, yeah.
Yeah.
Call it a style tool if you want to get
a style.
Yeah, style tool. That's a good one.
Yeah. I'm not trying to compare games, by the way. I was just kidding. That was a yoke.
Yeah. That was a yoke.
It was a yoke. I think that you know, there's the shoulders of giants things, right? So I mean, no game is original. Everything is borrowing from something else, and it's people that like to play games, and they see and remember something from a cool game, a piece from here and a piece from there, maybe a couple of original pieces in there because you know everybody's unique. In reality, though, you don't. Everything is a product of a something. A product,
right?
I'm not explaining it correctly, but you know.
No, you are.
Everything new has been inspired by something old.
Yeah, exactly. No, and that's exact. That's what I'm trying to say, right? So, that's the whole shoulders of giants thing, right? So, you get as far as you do in anything you do because somebody else did a whole bunch of hard work, and that's just the way it is. That's what it's all about, right? Yeah. So, anyways, so you know, if we mention, I just had to say that because you know, if you mention another game and all of that, you should. I don't see a big deal. I mean, there's tons of really cool games out there, right?
Now, are you gonna put Stairs in here?
Yeah, but I'm gonna put the mace. You know, that one of the nice things about this game is that there's like almost no penalty for picking stuff up.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, Dread, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like you don't have material loss.
Yeah, exactly. I think that's just awesome. It makes me happy. All right, that's all the masonry brick I have. Or
Oops.
The mortared stone, I guess.
Mortared stone, yeah.
Yeah, but I do have...
Did you get the stuff at your house?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, no, that? No, not yet. That's all that I have here right now.
Oh, okay.
This is a lot. I made a lot of more. Mm-hmm. Look at this all. It's crazy. But now we've got...
Oops, I'm in your way. Brick.
You're fine. I'll just encase you in a brick wall.
Yeah, just what I wanted.
Yeah.
Why does that look like... Wow, that was a terrible optical illusion. I was standing over here because of the way the tree was. For a minute, it looked like you had put the block on my right-hand side a block closer to me than the block on the left-hand side. It was weird.
Actually, I can sort of see what you're saying. Oh, look. Oh, there's a portal into a different universe there.
Oh, another one. There you go.
Yeah, isn't that awesome?
Great.
That was... Another world tear?
Yeah. No, just it happens when you lay in blocks down. Sometimes it fixes itself when you put another block down.
Yeah, it just, yeah.
Essentially. As soon as you put another block down, it went away.
Yeah.
Alternate universe.
Alternate universe.
Yeah, everybody should have another alternate universe.
Well, yeah, that's, that's where you escape to when the aliens come.
In Minecraft, we call that the mining world.
The mining world?
The mining world?
Yeah, it's the place you go to mine so you don't destroy the original world you're in.
Oh!
A lot of servers I either ran or had set up, we would do that so that, things could stay nice and clean.
You know what it reminds me of? There was a South African TV series. I can't remember what it was called. It was science, sort of science fiction, and it had portals to alternate dimensions and stuff. And why this company wanted to create a portal to an alternate dimension was because they wanted to exploit the resources of that dimension. So that just reminded me.
Are you talking about Avatar the movie?
No. That's a different planet. Oh no, that's a different. Yeah, no, it was called.
I never seen Avatar, so I really don't know.
I don't believe that Avatar was set in South Africa, but
no, it wasn't.
It was a cool TV show. I, I remember, but it was water played a big part in it. They were, I think there was a problem with water contamination in the heavily industrialized world, and they wanted to tap into and steal the water from, or take the water from
water world.
From an, well, no, it was just an alternate dimension that had ruined their world, right?
Ah, okay.
I'm not really...
Well, what you do is you find alternate dimension that's that's unpopulated and steal
from
there.
You're not talking about Terra Nova, are you?
No.
No.
No, that's the no. that was although I did like Terra Nova.
Nova, yeah, I love Terra Nova.
I was so sad when they got rid of that.
That was a great show.
I did too. It was.
I'm trying to remember what it was called. It was South African. It was a Canadian and South African, I think, collaboration. So, all right.
It sounds like a lot of. Sounds close to a lot of things I've seen, but I can't. Yeah. I don't think it's one I have seen.
Oh, I can't remember what it's called, but it was really good. I quite liked it.
You just reminded me. Oh no, I have not even started season two of The Expanse yet.
I haven't either. I have to see it. If the audience hasn't figured it out yet, I'm a huge science fiction fan.
I am too. That's why I'm sad we can't play any science fiction games in multiplayer.
Is that because what's that? No, but
no one else likes them.
Well, I like them.
I like them.
Actually, it's probably the audience doesn't necessarily like them, but
I could see that. I mean, it's...
Yeah. I think it depends on the game.
The three of us could try something like Hellion or something.
I think it. Oh God!
are you grumbly about Hellion because you don't like?
No, it would mean you'd have to buy a game.
It would mean I'd have to get yet another game, and I've been buying games like crazy. That's why. And I've got a bunch of games that I want to. That I can play and try and all of that. So, that's all.
I understand. No, I totally understand that.
So the question about that I have now for this place that I'm building is stairs.
Yeah, that was my question. How are you going to get upstairs? You're not going to just always use this little outside thing, are you?
I've been staring at that, like wandering around the building, staring at it. Now I make stairs in the workbench, right? Yeah, that's right. I thought I made stairs. I did. I don't know what I'm going to do about stairs because I want to split this room up in half. Dredd, if you need to tell your group, your people anything, just, you know, barge. I don't want
to. Oh, no. I have an industrial table that I'm trying to put down, but I have to have at least 18 blocks of corrugated steel as the wall. So I'm making that, and I'm just trying to size the room up because I want to put other things in here too. So that's all I'm doing right now.
Okay. I'm going to do something that looks silly at first, but it actually will make sense. Hopefully.
Dredd, does it have to be walls? Can it be like just the ceiling out of the steel?
Yeah, it can be. It can be other things. It doesn't have to be the walls, but. I kind of started a little bit of a modular building style over here where I build the columns out of mortared stone and then I put in panels of the different material.
Oh, okay.
And so it just makes it easy that way. So I'm just working on that. It's my second floor I'm adding on. You guys are far away, but as soon as you are over on the side of town, feel free to come check it out.
Yeah, I will. Now, you haven't put a factory in yet, have you?
No, Bish was going to put his factory in. Which I was going to get on his case a little bit and say, hey, you're not sharing any of the knowledge. I said, that you had. I built the books he already built. I wasted so many resources.
Oh, wow.
So that's just frustrating. It's I didn't have to, but yeah.
Yeah, that I can see how that would be frustrating.
Yeah, well. The, I was going to say something.
Uh-oh.
And I totally lost my train of thought. Uh-oh. And it was important, too. So are you going to make a second floor on here? Or is this just going to be entrance to the roof?
I can make a second floor. Oh, you mean up there? No, there's going to be... there's a second floor.
Oh, but okay.
The second floor is going to be like the whole... This whole expanse. This whole... this whole... Whatchamacallit?
This doesn't work too good.
Oh, just hang on.
Okay.
So what's wrong?
Whoa!
What's wrong?
The way the top doesn't turn, it just runs into the sideways stairs, and then you have to jump up, and then it throws you up over the side of the building.
Oh.
See? You go up here, and there's, like, not a landing where you can... Oh, never mind.
I know. I fixed it.
Nah, I gotcha.
I was being tricksy.
Gotcha.
Now, I'm going to put in the... what's that?
When I got to the top, right, I couldn't get over the sideways stairs, so I jumped up to get on them, and it threw me over the side of the building. I was like, this is not going to work too well.
I'm going to put in the mid-wall. Oh! Another portal. I've sealed it up.
There you go.
It's safe now.
I came flying down to see it, and you'd already sealed it.
Oh.
Oh, there's another one.
Oh.
That went away.
It's, weird. Yeah, they come and go. Those those portals to alternate dimensions are, they're tricky. Yeah, they're not reliable. Like
What was the name of that? It was a British show. It was out of the UK, I think.
Uh-huh.
Maybe it was out of Wales. I'm not sure. But it was about, portals would keep forming to alternate universes.
And dinosaurs would come out?
And dinosaurs would come out, yeah.
Yeah, that was actually... In the first couple of seasons, it was... was it New Zealand or Australia? In later seasons, though, that was Canada. That was Vancouver.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But it was Primeval.
Primeval, right. Primeval. But it was BBC, right?
Originally? Maybe? Yeah.
It was redone, or there was a... Not necessarily redone, but it got picked up in the U.S., and it was done on science... I think on Sci-Fi. A couple of seasons of Primeval were done. Oh, so they, and they ruined it. But the BBC version was great.
I don't know if it was BBC, but it was definitely... It could have been like ITV or...
Right.
Some other independent... but I do remember the show, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It was great. I loved it.
Oh, this is all...
I love the European version. Put it this... Why am I having so much trouble going up these stairs?
I don't know.
I'm going up the stairs. You just walk it.
Yeah. Well, see. Watch.
Okay. So I start here. And I go up. And it's like, doom, 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 doom. Like I get almost stuck on every step.
I'm getting the... I'm gonna have to do something about this. But what's that?
Like there's extra friction.
Mm-hmm.
I'm having the same thing on some of the stairs. I don't know why.
I know what you're talking about. Yeah, I've mentioned that before, and everybody thought I was crazy. Basically, where if you walk up on the side, it's kind of like your watch, like this. It's like your and then. Oh, I can't do it now.
But, I'm going up on the side, or whether I go right up in the middle,
you can do this.
I think.
You see where I am?
Mm-hmm.
Are my feet on the floor?
Not really. It's like your heels are on the step above, but your toes are floating over the step.
Yeah, I've noticed that too. There's definitely some weirdness with...
I see. If I'm near the wall, I get the jerkiness.
If you're pointing it at the wall as well, if you've got a slight angle and you're pointing into the wall and you go up, it, instead of it sliding, you sort of end up catching on it.
Yeah.
Is that what you're talking about too, Dredd?
Yeah, it just does. It feels like it's you're inching along per se.
Right.
I think we're talking about the same thing.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Now, I think one thing that you need to add is stairs and something other than wood.
I think so. Although, I don't think that... I think wood stairs are nice.
Mm-hmm. I think they're nice. That's not the problem I have. I just like sometimes I'd like them to match with the other building material.
That's true. I understand what you're saying.
Or... some kind of better wood material to put underneath them. So, because you've got them stacked on mortared stone, so they don't really match too well.
Now, the question is, this room that has the stairs,
mm-hmm.
is this going to allow for a workbench?
Good question.
I know. Let's find out. I might have to redesign because this could get messy. All right, let's take a look. I'm pretty sure I've got a carpentry table. I know I've got a carpentry table because I built extra ones. It was silly. I was not paying attention and I made a carpentry table instead of something else. Oh, and I've got a powered cart deed. Dread, would you like a deed to a fine powered cart?
That's okay. You can keep your deeds. I'm good.
You dumped one of your deeds in my chest.
No, I thought about that. I didn't dump anything in yours. I think what happened is Game Edge went around throwing deeds everywhere, right? Because he put a bunch in my chest. I think he picked one of my deeds up that I had in there for trash and took it over to you. I don't know if he did it on purpose or by accident, but yeah, I know I don't dump stuff on other people's property if I can help it.
I found one of your deeds.
But I remember you saying that in one of the videos, and I'm like, no, there's no way, because I just wouldn't do that.
No,
just because I don't like it. But
funny. I think 5.5, they said they're going to have some way to get rid of all those extra deeds. I think.
Oh, this one.
I should just burn it. I got fire, yeah. Right?
The carpentry table must be in a room built with at least 18 blocks of type log.
Oh, no.
That's okay. I don't.
Oh.
Okay, I can have a separate building or whatever for carpentry work. That's not a big deal. I just thought I wanted to test it with this.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not going to work. So.
Well, you could always build a mortared stone building and put paneling up in it.
One block thick paneling, two block mm-hmm. thick doors. Oh, good God. Mm-hmm. Oh, my. That would be, yeah. Nope, nobody wants that.
Okay, well, I'm just making a suggestion.
All right, well, I'm going to try. I've got... Oh, I can't pick this up because it's full. Oh.
Mm.
And it's got way too much crap in it. I'm not going to worry about that. And it needs... I need stone in order to...
Oh, it's got in. It's logs and dirt.
Oh, I've got stone.
Oh, I don't know what's in your private store.
Oh, it has more. Okay, let me make. Because really, a workbench is enough for testing.
All right.
Right. And so if I can put a workbench down, and it'll function, then that means that the room meets the requirements as far as purely for, you know, how many doors you're allowed to have and that kind of thing.
Right.
Without worrying about, you know, the materials of the building and that kind of stuff.
Right.
Have you run into that, Dread, where you have issues with stairways and stuff looking like more than a doorway?
Yes. So yeah. The trick is you put a doorway at the bottom or the top of the stairs.
Yes.
Now I do have a situation where my blast furnace is working great and I don't have a doorway there. What I've noticed, I'm looking at it right now, is it seems like if the stairs stop exactly where the hole opens for your floor to go down?
Yes.
Or up? Actually, up it doesn't work, but down it seems to work, where I have two wide stairs going down, no doorways. But it overlaps like just barely. It's hard to explain. I'm looking at it. But maybe that's not the case, because at the bottom I have like a kind of like a junction of doorways. So maybe I'm just completely off my rocker on this one.
I think that you are, and I'm just saying that just because. Well,
you're off your rocker.
Because you're off your rocker. Yeah. Oops.
I am, because I didn't like the way a table was turned, so I picked it up and I put it down the same exact way.
I'm coming over to see what Dred's building.
Oh, this is a carpentry table. What am I doing? Did I build another carpentry? Oh my god, I am going insane.
Are you starting a carpentry table collection?
I don't know what I'm doing. I think I picked the wrong thing up. I'm listening and building at the same. Oh, I picked up the wrong thing. That's all.
No, okay.
I'm just distracted.
Dred, did you leave the game?
I didn't mean to.
It says
they left the game.
It says Dred Pirate Duo has left the game.
Okay, well that makes sense then, because I suddenly can't interact with anything.
Ah.
Okay, I see. So I gotta put in my little crash screen at around 49, 40-ish.
Oh, the workbench needs to be in a log building too.
Oh, wow.
You put them together. They can be friends.
Yes, you'll have to have a building for two wood things.
Well, I don't know now. Worst case scenario, I put a wall where this bench is, and it goes out to here from floor to ceiling, and then I basically put a door here or something like that, or an opening. It doesn't even have to have a door. It just has to be a two-block opening, right? Door-shaped, right?
Right.
Doesn't have to actually have a door in it, right, Dred?
No, just two, one on top of the other.
Yeah.
And that's all you need.
Yeah. So I can, there's a workaround. I could make this work, but this could be an entryway, this room here. All right. Well, just pick this up.
Wow. What are these things? I haven't seen these before.
I don't know what
is. I'm over at Dred's place poking around.
Oh, you're. Oh.
Okay. That's his kitchen, obviously. Table, chairs, shelves. But what are these benches?
Are you upstairs?
Yeah. Oh, this is a machine shop. Oh, wow.
You're over here. There you are.
Yeah, there I am.
Oops.
So yeah, I put a farming table in over here, but it's pretty much useless.
No, is it?
Yeah.
So is that what this is?
Oh, no, in that room over there.
Oh, okay. This is a butcher table.
Pretty much. Well, it looks like a butcher table. It's really a farming table.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah, it's this farmer's table.
Use the same graphic. Yeah, I did say Ono. But the add-on I'm
So that's where the soiler sample comes from.
Exactly. The stuff I've been working on has been over here on this side, by the blast furnace up in this room here that you gotta step up into.
All right, so. I gotta come see this.
Now, what are these?
Oh, what's the up on the blocks there?
Cement kiln? Why is it on blocks?
Because I couldn't put it on the ground, or else when I'm down here in this particular, this chest I have in the ground here, I need to be able to talk to that and the blast furnace, so I need to put a space underneath it so I can do so.
Gotcha.
It's really, really ghetto.
So you can talk to the chest. Okay.
That's practical engineering. It's not pretty engineering.
And this is a blast furnace. Okay.
That's where a lot of my
smoke comes from.
That's where charcoal is made.
Marshmallows.
Oh, okay.
Marshmallow. It's your marshmallow factory.
Is that the thing that puts out all the smoke that I see from my house?
Yes.
Yeah, that's one of them.
Smoke? No. Marshmallows? Yes.
And then what's this building here?
What are you gonna put in here?
I put this industrial table in, which requires that corrugated steel, which you see in the back.
Oh, that's a steel.
I gotta see this corrugated steel.
Yeah, it looks pretty neat. Yeah, it does look kind
of
neat.
Because actually, I was thinking about it. It's not necessarily tin, but a lot of corrugated stuff is galvanized.
Mm-hmm. Right. So it's shiny. Yeah. This is not shiny.
Yeah, and you can polish steel. You can make polished steel. Yeah. There'll be attachment. But, I see what they're going for here. Probably shouldn't be called steel.
I don't know. I was thinking about it more like galvanized steel, right?
It's a nice alternative wall finish.
It is. It's just a very pricey one to make.
Mm-hmm.
Is there zinc in the game?
I don't think so.
Hmm. So it can't be galvanized then?
Right.
Hmm.
Well, if you're being totally logical.
So that means everything gets rusty. Is that right? That's right, isn't it?
That's right. That wall's going to rust.
You're going to have a rusty wall.
Steel rusts, right?
It does rust.
Yeah,
stainless steel is not supposed to, but it's treated a particular way to make it stainless.
Yes, and as someone once pointed out to me very forcefully, that there's no such thing as just stainless steel. There are numerous blends of metals, and it's an alloy, and there's so many different varieties, and that there's no one thing called stainless steel.
Mm.
It's like when you have your stainless steel like dinnerware, like your forks and knives, they can rust, right? We've had it over the years of using a dishwasher because it's abrasive. We've had it rust.
I've never had silverware rust.
Yeah, neither have I. I don't know where you're getting your silverware from, Dredd.
Well, of course, it's your dishwasher. It's Phoenix water, so I mean it's corrosive as beyond all get out. Anyway,
wow.
Can you bathe in it without losing layers of skin?
It's great for exfoliation, but
Oh my, what's this down here?
That's why everybody in Arizona is so skinny. They work there, and the water rots the outer layers off.
That's
also the sweat too.
Hello, Cupid.
That's right. Wait.
Uh huh.
I don't have any arrows really with me because they weigh. But I got my bow out.
All right. So what's this down? What? Oh, show me. What is your? You've made an extension here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, is this it here? I know what they're going for. I recognize this.
A lot of warehouses.
Yeah. It's pretty cool, actually.
I like the texture. It's pretty cool. I just wish it wasn't as expensive to make.
So I can't borrow it. Oh. Oh.
Oops.
Uh oh.
You put a hole in my wall.
No, I didn't. It's fine. Look, see, nothing happened. You didn't see anything. But there's nothing behind here.
Pay no attention to the thing behind the Ono.
Just ignore that scratch.
Yeah. I think I authorized everyone so they could use the equipment.
Yeah.
Just ignore the scratch, yeah.
I knew if I could take it down, I could put it back, so I wasn't too worried about it. and what's this? This is the
industrial workbench.
And in it, you can make industrial robot. Is this Skynet?
We're starting to make Skynet save us from the meteor, and then it's just gonna take us over anyway.
And then decide that humans are too dangerous for the planet. So the only way to that was actually in the beginning of the series. That was where I was going. I don't know if I actually ever said it when I said that I am the ultimate ecologist, essentially, there's only one way to ensure the survival of the planet, and that's to remove all of its inhabitants.
I want to see the robot.
Well,
it's just a piece that you put up that's a module for your factory.
Oh,
so
okay.
I don't think it'll be anything spectacular.
Yeah. It's robotics, but I wouldn't say it's a robot.
Oh, okay. So it doesn't, like, walk around and do cool.
Polishing station. I see. Is that, like, is that Daniel-san?
Yeah, it's wax on, wax off.
Wax on, wax off. Very good. Very good.
I like the Karate Kid movies.
I do, too.
I like the original ones. Really
no, the first one.
Yeah. I guess you've redeemed yourself in his eyes for not
you have?
Princess Bride.
Yes. Thermal.
Well, that's the thing is, I watched a ton of Princess Bride. I really liked the movie.
Yeah.
I didn't remember that line.
I didn't either. I've watched it many, many times and did not remember that line. I'm going to have to go watch it again now to see that line.
Maybe I'm the one that's crazy. Thermal cracking unit and a factory requires...
What's a thermal cracking unit?
It uses heat to crack things?
Hmm.
I guess.
I'm just basing it on the name. All right, what else do you have that's new and cool in here? Did you just jump out the window?
I did. I have a quick escape.
Yeah. Oh, it's tricky.
You're getting up over that.
Got it.
Yeah, so down here, I don't know if I showed you my little trick that I was doing with these, but in here I have my... What do you call it? I forget what this is called. This is an oil refinery where you can make epoxy and plastic and stuff, right?
Ooh,
where I made
I like epoxy.
For.
Epoxy is
ooh,
good.
Cool. Oh, is this where my plastics came from?
Yeah. And so basically I put these chests here in the wall so that I can easily transfer things out of my cart, and then I can just come in here and turn and transfer things into my oil refinery.
This makes me sad.
Yeah, it's not pretty.
Because look, you can see the outside.
Yeah, but see, you could come out here with some more brick and build a little thing around it, and then you wouldn't.
I could probably fill that in. Yeah. I also got my pump jack. I'm doing some offshore drilling here.
Oh, is that what this is?
Offshore drilling?
Yep.
Well, he's offshore.
There's
about
2 feet.
There's
a bug. There's a huge bug with the pump jacks.
Uh-huh.
And the oil refinery. So in order to get petroleum out of this, I have to have a barrel, right?
So a barrel? Okay.
I put a barrel in. It takes time to fill the barrel up, and I pull out a petroleum drum.
Okay.
So I move petroleum drum into the oil refinery, and I create plastic, right? I get my barrel back, which is really awesome. But because I've increased my efficiency, one barrel might equal 4 barrels of petroleum.
Okay.
Or four pieces of plastic, I get 4 barrels back.
Oh,
so
no.
Multiply my barrels.
Oh, no.
Oh, man. So I take it you have a chest that's holding barrels?
They've all been... In my oil refinery, I have 220 barrels of petroleum that I'm not doing anything with.
Oh, no.
And I started with 1 barrel, mind you. I'm at about 220 barrels that are in there. And... I'm not doing anything because I can't use the gasoline for anything useful.
Oh.
I was going to use that to power machines and my cart and everything, and it refused. It won't work.
What about...
Well, now, 5.5, you have to power carts, right?
I hope so.
But carts are steam-powered. You don't power them with gasoline.
Yeah, but you put fuel on them to produce the steam.
Yeah, but it's solid fuel, like coal or...
Oh, I thought it was liquid fuel.
Well, I might be wrong. I mean...
What's... No, it's the way that particular unit is. That's solid fuel. It's kind of like, man, what's it called? Wood gas. Have you ever seen like a wood gas implementation?
Are you talking now? Let me see. A rocket stove.
I don't know. I don't know if that's the name of what I'm thinking of.
I've seen a wood gas. It's basically where it's sort of a form of reburn.
Yeah, so basically you burn the wood, I guess, it's at a very low smoking point.
Yeah.
And that smoke is still, I guess, can still be burned.
Yeah.
So it makes
it
into an engine.
Yeah.
And it would reburn it.
Yeah.
And it's funny is I learned that from a show called The Colony.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess evidently they were in World War I or World War II or something when petroleum was low because the military was using it. People would convert their cars to run on this. It runs super slow, but it get the job done.
My wood stove does that.
Does it?
Yeah, it has reburn.
That's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, that's wood stoves, in order to get the EPA rating. It either has to use a catalytic converter or it has to do reburn. And the reburn, it has these pipes that go across the top, and it basically recirculates the smoke. And when the wood stove is going really well, it's got like this, the roof of the stove is like inside. It's like a broiler almost.
Cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Well,
I think we're running about an hour.
Yeah, and I think
are we really?
Yeah. So,
wow.
I think that I think we're good.
Yeah, we may have to cut this into a part one, part two.
I think that you're probably right.
Oh no! So, how do I cut?
What?
We can.
I haven't gotten into. I'm learning Adobe Premiere, but I haven't learned how to cut videos yet.
You have a video editing tool.
Yes, I know, but I haven't learned how to use it yet.
Oh, okay.
We'll figure it out. We'll get it. We'll cut it in the middle. Even with YouTube, I think we can cut it.
If you've got Avi Demux, it's free, and it's all it does is cut. It's a cutter.
Oh, okay. We'll figure this out.
Apologize to everybody right now that we lost track of time and we have to cut this because it'll be an abrupt cut. Or we'll cut it in the middle. And then we'll have to put in little titles saying, part one, part two. So.
Two, yeah.
Yeah, we got carried away. Oh, look!
Sorry.
Look at me, I'm the king of your oil thing.
All right.
And what I would love is if it was actually going up and down, I would be going up and down.
I can't figure out. I don't have any barrels for you to try it. I don't think it moves, though.
No, I don't.
It doesn't move? Oh,
I don't think so.
Aw.
Okay, well, really in that case, I'm just going to jump off the edge. Oh, I didn't die.
I know, offshore drooling. It's about a foot offshore and in waist-deep water.
Technically, it is offshore. Here's the shore.
It's off
the shore.
Yeah. Waist-deep water, I mean, yeah.
All right. Sorry, I distracted you from your clothes.
Saying goodnight. Yeah.
Yes, I did. I had to play with the pump jack.
Okay.
It's all good. So who brought us in?
Nobody did. We just kind of. I guess Ono kind of just said, "Dred's here and Pam's here."
Yeah.
So I guess we're just all saying goodnight, everybody.
Night all.
Hey, have a good one.
Good night. Bye bye.
Bye.